I teach a pull-out class. It's called Extended Learning Program. It's for advanced learners. So we were looking through the Utah history book, and we saw that there were pictures of the state symbols, but there was nothing about the state symbols. I teach problem solving in my class, so I thought this is a perfect chance to teach problem solving to these kids.
And we started this project when we were studying Utah history and symbols. And we found out that almost no one has seen the Sego Lily, which is our state flowers.
Of course you need steps for any project, so one of our first steps was taking notes and brainstorming ideas, even though it might not work as well.
My great, 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 great grandfather is Brigham Young. I wouldn't be here without the Sego Lilies.
Native Americans had told them that they could eat the bulbs of Sego Lilies for food.
That was the only food the pioneers had, so without Sego Lily growing and being here, they wouldn't have survived.
So it teaches them the strategies and techniques to accomplish a goal.
So we started writing letters to important people who might be able to help us in our project. And I wrote to one of the daughters of the Utah Pioneers. And the president of the Daughters of Utah Pioneers wrote back to me, and she gave us these. And they're silk Sego Lilies.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if, and just let them kind of dream.
So she gave us a bunch of these, and now we are creating pots to maybe stick these in. And I thought that was really cool because she addressed it to me.
And then teach them problem solving strategies. How do you find the problems first? What are the problems involved? And then what do you think is the main one? And what are all the possible solutions you could have?
And so to find out about opportunities like this going on, and finding ways that I can help improve, increase impact, make connections, just get more kids outside onto the public lands, building a love for nature, learning about the local landscape, and becoming stewards for that landscape.
This is a fun project. I'm glad that we finally got Sego Lilies because we've been working on it for so long and now we have seeds. And we can get them to other schools in Salt Lake City School District, so I think that's really cool.
The stewardship that they've taken in this of getting it out to the community, getting other schools involved, having other kids help in this, in any way is just really, really awesome to see.
I like learning about the Sego Lilies and trying to save them and making the PowerPoint. The PowerPoint was really fun. And there's me making the PowerPoint right there.
Let's move outside. Is umbrella under Michelle Obama's Let's Move initiative to get kids more healthy and active. My job is to do that outside. So I find all opportunities out in Salt Lake to get more youth and volunteers involved, to gain more stewardship, you know, do some service projects.
And it is so fun because their minds just go crazy. There's no ceiling on children like there is on adults.
We're going to give 8 Sego Lily seeds that were provided from us from BLM. And we're going to give 8 to every 27 schools in the Salt Lake City School District, so maybe they can have a chance to grow some, so their kids can see some, not just our school.
The knowledge base that they had, they were teaching me, I've probably learned over a dozen things about Sego Lilies today, the history of them, the importance of the Sego Lily to Utah, and also just how many people don't know about them. So to see the whole process that they had gone on, from the brainstorming to the reaching out, and getting just multiple partners and opportunities involved in this to become something so big and make real change, is really just so special to see.
I am glad because it saved the pioneers, so you should have a right to be the state flower, or else most of us probably wouldn't be here.